and CHIPKO movement leader Sundarlal Bahuguna, who recently passed away, and with his number of work, he has made us aware about the environment and the work which he have done for the environment. Before wasting any kind of time, I would request our principal sir to please preside over this webinar and give a keynote address for this webinar. To Principal Dr. Mazhar Ahmed Farooqi sir.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Respected resource person, Dr. Afreen, Dr. Rafiuddin Nasir sir, organizing committee, all the members, teaching staff and non-teaching and the students, participants. Actually, as all of you know, the importance of environment. We know the importance of the tree plantation. We know what is the effect of deforestation and everything here. Then what is the purpose of today's lecture? What is the purpose of today's session here? The purpose is that a renowned environmentalist, Sundarlal Bahuguna ji, now he passed away at the age of, I think, 94. And once again, this is the reason, this is the effect
of deforestation and everything here.
Yes, so the immediate, suppose the reason is that we have to remember the life and work of Bahuguna ji, and as well as his movement, and whatever the writings are there from Bahuguna. Actually, ये जो lecture series है, इसका और एक मकसद मैं यहाँ पर बताना चाहूँगा कि we are having green audit committee, we are having eco club on our campus. तो ये लोग जो है तो green का इसका काम करते ही है, इको क्लब का काम कर भी रहे हैं. इसके साथ साथ जो करंट अफेयर्स हो रहा है अभी, उसका जो है तो बच्चों तक फायदा पहुंचना, उनको पता चलना कि क्या क्या चीजें है. एमपीएससी यूपीएससी जैसे कुछ कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स अगर होने गए तो उन कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम के अंदर क्या इनके ऊपर सवाल आ सकते हैं. सो दे शुड हैव सम फैक्चुअल डेटा विद देम, और ये डेटा जो है तो इन लेक्चर के जरिए से उन तक पहुंच सकता है. जनरल एस्पेक्ट तो अपन कई बार देख चुके हैं, लेकिन फैक्ट क्या है, किस तरीके से मूवमेंट चली, कब चली, उसका क्या बेनिफिट हुआ, किसने स्टार्ट किया, कौन सी कम्युनिटी थी, ये सभी चीजें इन लेक्चर्स के सहारे से जब उनके सामने आएंगे तो दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु आर प्रिपेयरिंग देमसेल्फ फॉर एमपीएससी यूपीएससी एंड अदर कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जामिनेशन, दे विल गेट बेनिफिटेड आउट ऑफ दिस सच टाइप ऑफ लेक्चर सीरीज हियर. दिस इज द मेन पर्पज बिहाइंड दैट. और इसके अंदर एक चीज याद रखना है, जो स्टूडेंट्स यहाँ ज्वाइन हुए तो इन्होंने ये फैक्ट्स जो है तो नोट डाउन करके लेने के बाद में एडिशनल रीडिंग मटेरियल में से भी जाना चाहिए, और उसका जो है तो अपना नॉलेज अकॉर्डिंगली इनरिच करना है. और खाली यहाँ पर वो मूवमेंट क्या थी इतना ही जानकर फायदा नहीं है, बल्कि उसके क्या क्या जो है तो आगे इफेक्ट्स हुए हैं और किस तरीके से इन्वायरमेंट को बचाया गया है या नहीं बचाया गया है, उनकी सोच क्या थी, क्या इस तरीके से हमको इन्वायरमेंट को बचा सकते हैं, क्या हमारा डेवलपमेंट सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट जिसे कहा जा सकता है इन्वायरमेंट के जो है तो कॉस्ट के ऊपर कर सकते हैं या नहीं कर सकते, कितना जो है तो रिसोर्सेज, क्योंकि जो कुछ भी डेवलपमेंट होता है तो ये इन्वायरमेंट से ही उसका जो है तो रिसोर्स लिया जाता है, चाहे वो माइनिंग के तौर पर हो, चाहे फिर और किसी और तौर पर हो. नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज आर जनरली यूज फॉर द डेवलपमेंट पर्पस, तो यहाँ पर कितना एक्सप्लॉयटेशन उसका करना जायज है या कर सकते हैं, साइंटिफिकली आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू तो कितना कर सकते हैं, ये सभी चीजें जो है तो बच्चों ने रीडिंग मटेरियल में से एडिशनली जो है तो यहाँ पर जो निकालना चाहिए. और ये ऐसे मौके होते हैं जिन मौके का फायदा उठाना है. दैट्स व्हाई ये हमारी जो टीम थी, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग टीम, ये कोशिश कर रही थी कि हर एक स्टूडेंट तक, चाहे वो बीए रहो, बीकॉम रहो, बीएससी का रहो, ये जो है तो प्रोग्राम पहुंचे और उससे एक मुस्बत अंदाज से जो है तो वो काम लिया जाए. तो मैं यहाँ पर सभी को मुबारकबाद देता हूँ और इनको भी कांग्रेचुलेशंस कहता हूँ जो ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमिटी है. वेरी नाइसली ऑर्गेनाइज लेक्चर सीरीज इज देयर. सो आई विश बेस्ट ऑफ लक टू ऑल ऑफ देम. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
Thank you, sir. I would like to welcome our first speaker for today's lecture series, Dr. Mrs. Afreen Abrar Ahmed. Before saying something about her, I would like to give one of the important notice about that. She was the first batch student of BSc in Naukhanda College for Women. Today's Dr. Rafiq Zakaria College for Women. She is the former colleague of Department of Botany, Maulana Azad College. She was also associated with the Dr. Rafiq Zakaria Center for Higher Learning and Advanced Research since 2011 to 2016. She taught in our college for the BSc classes as well as for the MSc classes. She has near about 18 years of research experience and teaching experience. And when she was abroad in Saudi Arabia, she received Best Teacher Award in 2003 at Dar al-Hijra International School, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Currently, she is working as Assistant Professor in Botany at Pune College in the Department of Botany, Pune College of Art, Science and Commerce. Indeed, a very excellent and superb orator for today's lecture series. I would like to welcome Dr. Mrs. Afreen Abrar Ahmed. Madam, please take over the lecture.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, continue.
Yeah. I need permission to share the screen too. I have a PPT which I'll be presenting along with my speech.
Just share the screen.
Okay. Thank you so much. Yeah. Thank you, Ashfaq, sir. I'm quite humbled by the introduction you gave. Respected Principal, Maulana Azad College, Dr. Mazhar Ahmed Farooqi, Program Coordinator, Professor Arif Pathan, members of the Eco Club Committee, heads of various departments of Maulana Azad College, teachers, and their students. Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to one and all. Today is a very special day for me, a homecoming of sorts, being a part of the program at Maulana Azad College, the place that helped me groom and prepare for my career in teaching. This is a great opportunity. I thank everyone who helped me achieve my goals, especially the staff at Department of Botany, Maulana Azad College. Well, I have a few amazing photographs here and I'll be speaking on the topic, which is very relevant to the conditions we are facing today. We are facing a situation which is very grave, a pandemic which was never seen, and I do not know for how long this will go on. I just pray and hope this gets over very soon. I'll be speaking about the life and writings of Sundar Lal Bahuguna, a person who would, as we go through the slides, we'll get to know what a beautiful soul this was. A beautiful picture. I suppose there are students with us and when you look at this picture, you feel really nice. You see the snow-covered mountains. You see greenery all over. You see the trees, different kinds of trees. Of course, I missed out the flowers and fruits here. And this is an indeed a very fascinating picture. فَبِأَيِّ آلَهَا إِرَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Then which of the favors of your Lord will you deny? Surah Rahman, 55th chapter of the Quran. The bounties of nature, the gifts of the Almighty are countless. Shouldn't we be grateful for every breath we take, every morsel we eat, the luxuries we enjoy, and all those obtained from nature, roti, kapra, or makan, isn't it? A human being's existence is because of the clean air, water, the various fruits, vegetables, the enormous kinds of food, medicines, every product which you obtain from nature, the forest. The list is unending. But what have we given to earth? What have we given to nature in return? Just take a look at this picture. This picture very well tells us what we are doing to nature, what we are doing to earth. Instead of giving a balanced life to our younger generation, keeping the earth clean, pure, using resources in a proper manner. Look at the burden we have put on Mother Earth. Is this gratitude? Not at all. We have created a havoc for ourselves. But surely there is hope. We can try to repair the damage done with effort, starting at the very individual level, especially with the youngsters, you students who are listening to this very program. How do we get started? Can we really bring about a change as an individual? Of course, yes. This is a slide which shows what we are doing to the biodiversity. What are we, what is the havoc that has been created in the past few years? So let me come back to the hopeful part where this is the pollution we have created. This is just one example of water pollution. So let's come to the hopeful part. There is a great example before us of a very, very simple man from the hills, Uttarakhand, who pioneered. In fact, he made us aware that nature, its biodiversity, the air, the water, mountains, rivers, every bounty should be cared for, preserved, and conserved for us and for the future generations. This is the great Sundarlal Bahuguna, the earth warrior, as we call him, who dedicated his life to save the environment. Born in Tehri, Uttarakhand, in the year 1927 on January 9th, as a boy with a very, very pure heart. And at a very tender age of just 13, he joined the freedom struggle. This is way back in the year 1930s I'm talking about. He was so passionate about his activities. He even faced imprisonment at a very young age of just 17. But this pushed him more into politics, and he started mobilizing people against the colonial British rule before the year 1947. He was focused on constructive activities also. However, it was only in the year 1949 when he met the social activists Mirabai and Thakur Bapa that he was inspired to begin his journey in social work. One of his first moves, what I've given you here, is to start up a small school for the poor students of the communities in the Himalayan tract. These communities lived totally on forest products, whatever they could earn out of that, and they lived in harmony with nature. And here he worked for these downtrodden communities. He thought even these communities deserve education and they need to be uplifted. And he also worked more for the Harijans. This was all because of the inspirations and the principles of Mahatma Gandhi. Though his guide was Dev Suman, together they were great followers of Mahatma Gandhi's principle of nonviolence. On the home front too, I have a photograph of his wife, which we'll see later on. 11 years later, after imprisonment, he found that he needs to work for the depleting conditions of taking Sundarlal Bahuguna's works forward. Let's go through a life sketch. Taking inspiration further from Vinoba Bhave, he started spreading his message further. He started padyatras across the hills, and people slowly, slowly understood the message that he wanted to convey. His message was very clear, which even people saw with their own eyes. They saw the real, the reality of ecological degradation in the Himalayan catchments, which were very close to the rivers there. And that was mostly because of human activities. It wasn't a natural disaster. It was false activities carried out by the local, you can say, the businessmen there involved in timber industry, and there was rampant deforestation. So his motive was to draw attention to all these grave situations. Now, one bad human activity leads to another, and this slowly has an impact on the environment, the ecology, the other natural resources. Slowly, slowly, this gave rise to the danger of floods in the Himalayas, the glaciers, melting glaciers. Slowly, slowly, the danger of floods arose. So he started to bring the government and the local people's attention towards this upcoming danger. He began to mobilize people, and he did this very coolly, calmly, following the principles of non-violence and satyagraha. He protested against the felling of trees. And this was his very first step in laying the foundation for the Chipko movement. Chipko is to hug the trees and stop their felling or cutting down the trees. This took on a very big nature later on, and it became a very big movement, and now it's a very well-known movement known the world over. So what he told his people to attract them towards his motive was, today the Himalayas are calling you. Wake up, my son. Do not allow my auction. Protect me from being slaughtered. So these are the words he spoke on behalf of the trees over there, on behalf of the forest. And this is his soulmate, his wife, Vimla Devi. She was a very strong support during all his different satyagrahas, padyatras, and during his writings, whatever books he wrote, she was a strong support. Of course, when he married her, it was only on one condition, that they would live in a rural setting and start an ashram there. And she readily agreed. This was the fire in this young man to serve the society, and his wife supported him a lot. Slowly, slowly, these long foot marches across the hills became on a much larger scale. He took up a 120-day walk of 1400 kilometers in the year 1973. That was the year when the Chipko movement started. Another walk of 2800 kilometers in Uttarakhand in 1975. And furthermore, 4870, that's very, very long. A walk from Kashmir to Kohima from 1981 to 83. And during these endeavors, people kept on joining him because they found that what he was saying was in turn beneficial for them. For commercial purposes, government had been felling down, cutting.
Audible, sir. I would like to thank our webinar speaker, Dr. Mrs. Afrin Ahmed, for speaking, sparing her time and enlightening us with her knowledge. It gave deep insights into the topic and also revealed some interesting facts about Sundarlal Bahuguna. The information shared by Dr. Afrin Ahmed will definitely help us in our studies in environment. Now, our next speaker for today's lecture series is
technical problem. Ashok sir, you are not audible. Ashok sir, unmute yourself.
More than 130 radio talks. He is currently associated with research students. He is in research guide for JJTU Universities, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Maharashtra University. He has visited n number of countries, and he is the national awardee teacher of 2008, state level awardee teacher, Maharashtra Sahityik Award, to count some. I would like to and request Dr. Rafiuddin Naseo, sir, to please preside over the lecture.
Thank you, Dr. Ashfaq Khan, Principal Dr. Mazhar Ahmed Farooq, sir, convener Dr. Sayyed Sultan sahab, coordinator Dr. Ashfaq Khan, members of all Green Audit Club members, as well as members of Eco Club, Dr. Afreen Ansari, Assistant Professor, Pune College, Pune, all my dear friends, inside the campus, outside the campus, and especially all the students, those who joined from our campus as well as outside the campus. Good morning and assalamu alaikum to all of you. Actually, the main aim behind this particular seminar to provide the information about personalities like Sundarlal Baguna and movements like Chipku movements to all the students, and that knowledge is somewhat useful for benefit of different competitive examinations. Dr. Afreen has given a lot of information about Sundarlal Baguna, but unfortunately due to technical problems, she is unable to share his publications as well as his work, his movements, his awards, and that is all already available on different needs and different aspects. So we will just go through that particular information. Now, we are running short of time. I would like to discuss with this Chipko movement. Actually, as she told that this movement is related with the plant protection as well as conservation of plant species, as well as whatever the biodiversity is there in that particular area. That movement is started with this particular aspect, and we'll find that this movement later on got a lot of respect, and still we are following this particular aspect. This movement is the Chipku movement is started in 1973 in Uttarakhand. At that time it was in Uttar Pradesh, and later on it is spread in the different parts of the area and different part of the country. The birth of this Chipku movement is taken by the Gauri Devi. She is a elderly woman, and she is a head of that particular village, and ultimately she started and mobilized village women for the movement when the company men marched to cut the trees. That history we'll discuss briefly after some time. And as Dr. Afreen told that Sundarlal Baguna is a founder of this one. Actually, systematically started this particular movement, that is Chipko movement. And as we got the information that this is a non-violent movement, means there is no any type of any terrorism in it. It is just simple and non-violent movement, means simply without any agitation, without any harm agitation, this movement is started. And that is started from a village named as a Chumoli and in 73. And what's happened, that women has played a very important role in it. And that woman goes, it just will discuss after some time. And they have that particular trees. Wo trees ko jo hai to lapat jate the, chipak jate the usse. And that's why very popularly it is known as a Chipko movement. Is wajah se ye movement ka naam jo hai to चिपको मूवमेंट रखा हुआ है। अब इसके पीछे जो बैकग्राउंड है दैट इज रिलेटेड विद द इंडो चाइना वार 1963 में, जब इंडिया और चीन के बीच जब जंग हुई। आपको मालूम होगा कि इसी जंग के बाद निजाम ने 65 टन गोल्ड गिफ्ट दिया था इंडियन गवर्नमेंट को, पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू को, और आज तक का रिकॉर्ड है कि दुनिया में इस तरह का गिफ्ट किसी ने किसी को भी नहीं दिया। तो दैट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर बैकग्राउंड व्हाट्स हैपेंड कि ये उत्तराखंड और उत्तर प्रदेश का जो हिमालयन रीजन था वो बहुत डेंस फॉरेस्ट से भरा हुआ था। इस वजह से वो जो बाद के इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट थे और बाद के जो डेवलपमेंट करने वाले लोग थे उनकी नज़रें उस फॉरेस्ट के ऊपर बहुत ज़्यादा थी, और नतीजा ये होता हुआ कि वो ये जंगलों को काटने के लिए हर तरह से कोशिश करते हैं। मतलब ये हुआ कि दे आर सपोज टू डिस्ट्रॉय दैट फॉरेस्ट एंड लोकल पीपल इज इंटायरली डिपेंडेड ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर फॉरेस्ट। वो उससे लकड़ियाँ काटते थे अपने फ्यूल के लिए और बहुत सारे एस्पेक्ट के लिए, लेकिन ये जो भी इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट थे वो जो है तो फॉरेस्ट काटा करते थे, और उसकी वजह से जो है तो फिर सॉइल इरोजन होता था, पानी वाटर शॉर्टेज होता था, एंड नंबर ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स दैट क्रिएटेड ओवर देयर। और फिर उसका नतीजा ये हुआ कि लोगों में अवेयरनेस आना शुरू, and that first awareness is come from a Gandhian social activities Chandi Prasad Bhatt, and he formed established a organization called as a Dasholi Gram Swarajya Sangh, later it is called as a Dasholi Gram Swarajya Mandal DGSM, and from here that actually he started to agitate about that particular unwanted destruction of the forest, because it created a lot of abnormalities. Floods comes over there at that time in 1964. And 200 से ज़्यादा अफ़राद उसमें जो है तो बहकर इंतकाल कर गए, और वो in that particular area it was a so great disaster for that country, and it is very difficult to manage that particular disaster. Later on, this DGSM in 1970. They started that particular education agitation, and in 1973 in Alaknanda Valley, that villagers are denied to what you can say that interruption for this particular aspect, and later on. Later on, this agitation become a great agitation. Excuse me for some time. This agitation becomes somewhat abnormal, and you can say that great agitation. And if you go through the outline of this particular agitation, so we will find that this Chipko movement actually started, and later the main behind this one to preserve the to preserve and conserve the forest with non-violent movement, and that people proceed for that one, and it, the beginning is 1970, and due to hug or stick the trees, that movement is called as a Chipko movement, and this movement is they inspired from that Bishnoi's movement that is taken place in 17th century against that particular ruler, and successfully it is still running that particular one. Then later on, this Chipko movement is having, as I told you, that one, there is a shortage of livestock, there is a shortage of water, there is a shortage of fuel, there is a shortage of good air, and ultimately awareness created a lot of problems. Even that shortage of malnutrition is there, and ecological balance of the region has taken place. Poor conditions, that landsliding is taking place in large quantity, water scarcity is there, and government is not taking any action against that particular woman. Then ultimately people started that one. And especially women plays very important role. And from 1970, then 73, then 74, that Gaura Devi, as I shown you, that that they have just opposed and they have discussed, they have debated with the loggers, those who cut the trees, those who cut the plants, they prepare the woods for that one. They just fight against them and with a great, what you can say, education and many other places. And even though that peoples were not ready for this particular cutting of the trees, and government is against these people. So what's happened? Then they hug the trees, they attach that trees, and that Chipku movement is started. And this is the particular area where this Chipku movement has started, especially in Gopeshwar. And that in first that agitation continued. Later on, that agitation continued with the aim that we are supposed to protect the forest and we are for various purpose and to maintain the Lal Bahuguna. They have systematically, Lal Bahuguna itself shows, enlightened the country for about the movement, its success and its impact on that particular aspect. Later on, his movement continued and he got different recognitions up to Padma Bhushan and many other things Dr. Afrin has explained in detail. And this Sundar Lal Bahuguna's activity later on continued. And then many pupils, they joined this Chipku movements, many workers, and they appealed, and especially women that has cooperated for this particular movement, and that women plays very important role for this particular movement. That if you are able to see this particular slide, you will find that women just attached these trees, and they chipak jaate the uske wajah se, and that results in the formation of movement, and that is considered as a Chipku movement. And the most important characteristic behind this successful of this Chipku movement is that one is spread that there is no any type of violence. Then it is a protection of the environment, and that's why it is spread in many parts of the state, and that Uttarakhand, then Uttar Pradesh, as well as in different Western Ghats region, especially Himalayan region. And that agitation generated pressure to change the natural policy for deforestation purpose. And after that one, they achieved a lot after a lot of struggle. In 1918, they got a lot of achievement. That means that 15 years their struggle got the result that they ban on grain felling in the Himalayan forest. This is the grain achievement. And most importantly, that this agitation saved more than 1 lakh trees in the, from that particular atmosphere. Then we'll find that again this agitation is gone through that bare lands, as well as they grow the different type of plants over there, and this activity continue. Then later on, in 1981, more than 1 million trees had been planted through their efforts to see that what they are doing or that one. And this activity is still in progress. And we are supposed to take the lesson from that one, that they have planted this more than 1 lakh tree. How much we are planning? How much we are planting? Our principal is taking a lot of efforts to utilize the barren land of our campus for this green tree. Dr. Ashfaq has planted many plants out there in that barren land or just plain land in our campus during this lockdown period. as a student, as a staff member, how much we are involved in that particular aspect, we are supposed to think about it. So we find that this situation is highly stable, and we'll find that this particular aspect a lot of impact to our society. Just we are having a short of time, so I will this movement continues, and they are discussing that principle is arranged. This one, their seminar, due to that seminar, more than 5,000 kilometers for awareness purpose in Tehri Garhwal district in Uttarakhand, and as well as they also stopped many land mines, and ultimately they have protected this one. And this protection, or you can say that this impact is still in progress, and we'll find that we are supposed to apply this particular movement to our day-to-day life. That's why we can, due to that one, we can protect this particular plant species, and we survive in very nice and very great manner, because each and every part of the plant is quite useful. That's why the very famous Persian poet Sheikh Sadi said in Persian that barge darakhtane sabz dar nazar hoshia har varak hai daftare ist marifat ke liye, means that a part of the leaf which is created by a single leaf of the plant which is created by the nature or almighty, if you go through the study of that particular leaf, so we required a number of files, number of offices for a study of single leaf. So this much is the advantage of that one, and we are supposed to take care of this particular movements, and we are supposed to protect this one. Dr. Ashfaq has advised me to conclude. So thank you, sir, for this one, and thank you for listening me and giving this particular opportunity to sharing this one. Over to Dr. Ashfaq, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like Dr. Sheikh Tarannum ma'am to please give vote of thanks. Over to Dr. Sheikh Tanvi Tarannum ma'am.
Arif, sir.
Yes, thank you very much, ma'am, sir.
Yes, madam.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Good morning, one and all. It was a wonderful and scholarly lecture. I express my gratitude to my friend, Madam Dr. Afreen Abrar Ahmed, for her excellent presentation on life of writings of Sundarlal Bahuguna. Lecture was full of knowledge and informative. It gave deep insight into the topic. I express my sincere thank to our principal, Dr. Mazhar Ahmed Farooqi, sir. He, as he highlighted the aims and the importance of the webinar and encouraged the student for the competitive exam as well. For this, I thank our principal, sir, and the entire organizing committee for organizing lecture series, which will surely helpful for student and staff. I thank our principal, sir, for always supporting and encouraging us to work for the development of students, staff, and the institution. I also thank senior faculty member, Dr. Rafiuddin Nasir, sir, head Department of Botany, and I also thank the chairman of Eco Club Committee for delivering a lecture on impact of Chipko movement in lucid way. I'm pretty sure that the precious knowledge that was given by the both the speaker will definitely help us for the forest conservation and to save the environment. I express my sincere thanks to the chairman of Green Audit Committee, Dr. Ashfaq Mehboob Khan sir, for his kind cooperation and support. I offer my gratitude to Professor Dr. Arif Pathan sir for providing us all the necessary technical support to make this event live. I also thank Vice Principal sir, that is Professor Dr. M.A. Bari sir, for his enthusiastic support. Last but not the least, I thank our IQSC coordinator, Professor Dr. Aditi ma'am, Dr. Rajan Shinde sir, Professor Dr. Sultan sir, organizing committee members of Eco Club and Green Audit, and all the staff members who are participated and all the participants. Thank you. Thank you very much, one and all. Jazakallah khair.